So last week I put out a clip talking about how you could slash the amount of time and effort you spend in creating the subtitles for your videos. The workflow I described involved exporting an audio clip from your final video sequence, bringing that into Otter.ai, which is going to process that. It's going to use automated speech to text to create a transcript. We're then going to take that transcript, proofread it, and then once that's done, bring it into Descript. And in Descript, we're going to use a free function that's going to match or sync the transcript to the source file. And that's going to create an SRT. An SRT is a file which contains all the text and time code information for each specific caption block. I was particularly impressed by the accuracy of the transcript produced by Otter.ai. Obviously, the more accurate the transcript automatically created by the artificial intelligence processing, the less time you're going to need to spend proofreading and editing the transcript before you progress. And because that stage, editing and proofreading, is really the only stage where you need to commit time and effort yourself to get the right results or to get the best results, then that's really important. Now, one of the viewers of the clip left a good suggestion. Have I tried Subtly? He asked. Now, I'd never heard of Subtly, so obviously I'd never tried it, but I am always looking for ways to work smarter and take away some of the burden of something like creating subtitles for videos, which are really, really important, but can be a chore. So I decided I'd give Subtly a real go. Subtly are in their beta phase. Before full launch, they're offering free use of the service, so now's a good time to try them out. Whereas Otter.ai and Descript's transcription services cover a range of possible uses, such as podcasts, interviews, lectures, and meetings, Subtly seems very much targeted at short-form social media videos. I may have overlooked this, but I could not find information on the site about maximum length of videos or maximum file size for upload, which would be good to know. It seems very straightforward. Sign up, upload a video and have Subtly's AI process speech to text. Then within Subtly, you can either edit before exporting a video with subtitles visible or export the transcript as either plain text or an SRT. I'm not interested in exporting a video with subtitles burnt in. I just want to have a transcript created on this occasion. So let's go about doing that. For me, accuracy is key. Here, Subtly offers some data, claiming a word error rate between 20 to 25%. Interestingly, they make a comparison with Watson, IBM's AI platform. In my previous clip, I did use the demo version of IBM Watson and was not impressed. Subtly claims to be more accurate than Watson. I hope so. Let's give it a go. So we're in Premiere, and this is the project that I used in the previous clip as the source file for the transcription. I'm going to use the same clip, even though I've already obviously created the SRT as part of the previous clip. I want to use the same source file to try and keep things as consistent as possible. Previously, I exported an audio file. This time, I'm going to export a video file, which is what Subtly requires. Now, this is a 13 minute 47 or so second clip. And if I exported that at a high resolution, it would probably be quite a large file. So I'm going to export it just using the Twitter 720 preset in Premiere. Now, if like me, you're just interested in using something like Subtly to create the SRT file rather than creating a video with subtitles burnt in, then at this stage, you do want to make sure that if you've used any music, you mute those music tracks. And of course, as always, your audio tracks for dialogue have already been optimized, so they're nice and clear. Basically, you want the dialogue to be as clear as possible to give the AI the best possible chance to transcribe correctly. So I've created a free account within Subtly, and it's very straightforward. I'll just upload the file I've just exported. I'll confirm from the drop-down list of languages available the language spoken in the video, and it's got a couple of different variants for English. I've obviously gone for British English. And then I'll initiate the processing, which will convert speech to text and create the subtitles. So that sequence of 13 minutes, 47 seconds, which is mainly dialogue, took about 5 minutes for Subtly to process. And once it's processed, you can see the video with the subtitles displayed. Hey guys, in this clip, I'm going to show you how to use this camera, the JVC GY LS300, to stream directly into YouTube. Once you've set it up, the sync seems to be fine, but I can already see some errors with the transcript. Also, you'll immediately see that there is a watermark added by Subly. You can obviously understand why they've done that, but it's pretty much a non-starter for me if that were mandatory. But fortunately, they do allow you to remove the watermark within the style editor, so you don't have to live with that. Certainly at this beta stage, there will always be errors. You've just got to accept that that is part of this process. Even with services which claim a very high accuracy rate, I'm talking 99% or so, accept the fact that there will be errors within a transcript. As far as I'm concerned, you've always got to proofread the transcription closely. That said, you obviously want as accurate a starting point as possible. If you are using Subly to export a video with subtitles burnt in, then you would use the interface here to make your corrections. That's not the case for me, but I wanted to give it a quick try. The interface seems very straightforward. The only thing I didn't really like is that the transcript doesn't seem to automatically scroll with playback of the video. You need to manually find where you are in terms of the transcript to make the relevant corrections. So once you've edited the transcript, you can go ahead and download either an SRT or a plain text file. I'm going to download a plain text file for the next stage. So here is the transcription produced by Subly now in a plain text file. And all I'm going to do is copy the entire contents of that and paste it into a Google Doc. The reason to do that is that native plain text apps like Notepad can be a bit of a pain to edit within. And here's the transcript of the same sequence exactly as produced by Otter.ai. And I'm just going to compare the two. All I do is play back the source file and closely read the transcript, correcting as I go. I'm looking for words that have been mistranscribed or words that have been omitted entirely during processing. Apart from minor punctuation changes, which can be open to individual preference anyway, a much more significant problem across all AI speech-to-text processing is ending sentences at the wrong point. You can do this editing in Subly within the interface provided. As I say, in my case, I'm not interested in exporting the final clip from Subly, so I've taken the transcript outside the platform. It also allows me to edit the Otter.ai transcript in exactly the same way, so we can treat them like for like. Since this is a near 14-minute clip, another version of which I've already edited previously, you'll understand, I hope, why I didn't want to do it all again. Instead, I limited my proofreading to about the first minute for both transcripts. In fairness, that's probably representative of the duration of many of the clips that will be imported into Subly anyway, I'd guess. As I edited, I kept a note of the major changes I needed to make. The results from this head-to-head across the first minute of the transcripts were 5 corrections made in the Subly transcript, compared to 3 major corrections in the transcript produced by Otter.ai. So what did I think of Subly after my little trial? Well, I thought it was a good product. I thought it was very easy to use, straightforward to kind of set up the account, bring in the file, initiate the processing, foolproof there, I say, which a lot of people really appreciate. Accuracy was really, really important for me to get some sort of idea about. And I do think it offers an accurate transcription, certainly more accurate than some of the others I've tried. Not as accurate as Otter.ai based on my limited testing of it. But I have used that source file across a couple of different platforms, so I'm very happy to use that as a benchmark, at least for myself. Based on what I've seen, the transcription isn't as accurate as Otter.ai. The big question mark, of course, about Subly is what the pricing structure is going to be. They've opened it up, it's a beta stage, and so you're welcome to go and try it and get a feel for the product. And when they do release the pricing structure, you'll be able to take a view about whether that works for you. Personally, I'll probably go on to sign up for Otter.ai because I have found that, overall, a very good platform for me and my workflow. And also, obviously, I know what the pricing structure will be, which is less than $10 per month. So those were my thoughts on Subtly for subtitling your videos. If you've enjoyed this clip, a like is always welcome. If you want to watch the clip that I've referenced that talks in depth about how to create an SRT file for your captions and your subtitle workflow, take a look at the clip that's on screen right now, where I go, as I say, comprehensively, step by step, what's involved in that workflow. And if you're just interested in creating better content, consider subscribing, because that's what this channel is all about.